Freedom. The freedom to choose. Elections, the essence of democracy. And the choice to cast a vote, its strongest principle. People, irrespective of their caste, colour, creed and gender, exercise that very right to choose the political mandate for India, the largest democracy in the world. As the country is gearing up to hold a mammoth democratic exercise, it's one man, one vote.
At the stroke of the midnight hour, when the world sleeps, India will awake.
It was a gamble, it was an act of faith, principally on the part of Jawaharlal Nehru. From the late 1920s, had been convinced that when India became free, we must have universal adult franchise. We talk about the 20s when women did not have the vote in many Western countries. But Nehru particularly, the Congress Party as a whole, Gandhi also, but Nehru particularly was absolutely committed to universal adult franchise. And in many ways, that is his greatest achievement. Against strong opposition, the RSS general, the organizer said, Pandit Nehru will live to regret the day when he decided on universal adult franchise. Now they are in power because of Pandit Nehru's universal adult franchise.
Bharatiya Lok Tantra संपूर्ण विश्व में अपनी परिपक्वता व स्थिरता के लिए जाना जाता है इसका सारा श्रेय भारतीय मतदाता को जाता है और मतदाता को ये शक्ति दी है हमारे संविधान ने
Over 900 million voters will exercise the power invested in them by the Constitution of India. The grand exercise will begin on April 11th and continue for over a month till May 19th across seven phases. The counting of votes will be held on May 23rd. It's dramatic, it's emotional, and a spectacle like no other. With 15 million first-time voters, 1 million polling stations, more than 1,500 political parties and around 8,000 contestants will fight for 543 Lok Sabha seats.
हम आज भी गिनीज बुक में अपना पिछला रिकॉर्ड साफ करते हैं और नया वर्ल्ड रिकॉर्ड बनाते हैं हमने साबित किया है भले ही पार्लियामेंट में गुंडे चुन के चले जाएं लेकिन हम चुनाव में गुंडागर्दी नहीं होने देंगे
इंडिपेंडेंट इंडिया हैज विटनेस्ड 16 लोकसभा इलेक्शंस इन 1952 अ यंग नेशन केम टू लाइफ थ्रू यूनिवर्सल एडल्ट फ्रेंचाइज व्हेन द फर्स्ट इलेक्शंस वर हेल्ड वोटिंग सिस्टम इन इंडिया हैज गॉन थ्रू मल्टीपल चेंजेस ड्यूरिंग द फर्स्ट टू जनरल इलेक्शंस Each candidate was allotted a separate ballot box pasted with the symbol of the candidate. In 1960-61, a marking system on the ballot paper was introduced. This system continued till the 1999 Lok Sabha elections. The electoral magnitude has grown bigger, marching along India's fragmented and hyper-competitive democracy.
पेपर पर मुहर लगाने की बजाय मशीन का एक बटन दबाया और उनका वोट पड़ गया लोग उत्सुक भी थे और हैरान भी
उसी पर यहाँ मतलब निशान पे अंगूठा से दबाया तो आवाज़ आई पी पी तो सरदार जी ने बोला कि हाँ अब हो गया
बटन दबाने में बस अच्छा ही लगा
मोड़ना नहीं पड़ा
मोड़ना मारने में तकलीफ होती है समझ में नहीं आता इतना
Electronic voting machines or EVMs were introduced in 1982 and were used for the first time in 50 polling stations of Kerala's Parur constituency. They were challenged immediately as the law in the constitution mentioned ballot paper till an act was passed in parliament allowing the use of electronic voting machines. They were used in state assembly elections for the first time in 1998. 2019 election will use 1.1 million electronic voting machines and 100% machines are now VVPAT enabled. In a first, photographs of candidates will be added to the EVMs to avoid confusion over similar names.
Notice the two. The voter presses this and checks what gets printed on the VVPAT. Okay.
So I have chosen to press key number 8, whose candidate is HHH and symbol is theta. You have got HHH, symbol theta and key 8.
When the voter is casting his vote on the ballot unit, he actually sees a print coming out on a printer which has the candidate symbol and the name attached to it. So he is assured that that vote is now being secured. If there is any conflict, the VVPAT votes can be counted and his vote will then be taken into account, this matter. So this is a basic idea of the EVM, that this is a standalone unit, doesn't talk with anybody else. The second part is, how does he, like in a ballot paper, you can later on count the actual printed ballots. They are physically available and kept in a box as such. For that, the voter verified paper audit trail is storing all the votes counted by the voter as such, right? And one can always match these votes if there's any kind of a doubt on it.
The EVM has been mired in controversies in the recent past. Allegations have been made that the machine can be tampered with and the votes of one political party or candidate can be easily transferred to another. But the Election Commission of India maintains that EVMs are tamper-proof.
Electronic voting machines mein universally problems hain. Aur agar desh ki janta EVM mein ko dekhkar uncomfortable hai, to wo ek bahut bada sawal hai.
मैं दिखाना चाहता हूं कि इस प्रजातंत्र की नींव ऐसी मशीनों के ऊपर टिकी हुई है जिसको मेरे जैसा एक साधारण इंजीनियर भी 10-15 दिन की मेहनत के बाद जहां वो डलवाना चाहे वहां वो डलवा सकता है.
बहुत से इंजीनियर्स ने प्रेजेंटेशन किया है कि ईवीएम के पूरे सिस्टम को मैनिपुलेट किया जा सकता है, तो ये गंभीर विषय है.
इन्होंने ईवीएम में गड़बड़ी बेईमानी करके उत्तर प्रदेश में अपनी सरकार बनाई है, मुझे पूरा भरोसा था.
एवरी पॉलिटिकल पार्टी एट सम पॉइंट ऑफ द अदर हैज चैलेंज द मशीन बट दे हैव वन विद द सेम मशीन्स एंड लॉस्ट विद द सेम मशीन. सो वेयर एज इलेक्शन कमीशन हैज बीन सेइंग दैट आवर मशीन्स आर वेरी डिपेंडेबल रिलायबल.
Hari Prasad Vemuru, a technical researcher from Hyderabad, was arrested from his residence in August 2010. Hari Prasad hit the headlines for all the wrong reasons when an EVM went missing from an electorate in Mumbai. Hari was part of a three-member global team that sought to prove that Indian EVMs had their flaws and claimed that they could be hacked and tampered with.
2010, Election Commission of India made a challenge which is similar to the 2017-18, where they asked the experts, technical experts, to come and expose or demonstrate whether these machines can be hacked.
Hari Prasad, surely challenged it along with two professors, but they were not able to prove it. It was only an allegation.
In 24 hours, we could able to penetrate everything, video shoot everything and expose it.
We made the machine cheat by tampering with the hardware. We opened the machine and replaced the real display with this dishonest look-alike version, which lies about the election results.
One machine which was stolen from the collectorate of Bombay, they did some retro engineering on it, connected some external device which can be manipulated by Bluetooth, and which altered the display, did not change the results in the permanent memory, but altered the display. And but one of thing, but No telephones are allowed inside the polling booth.
It's not the 2010 challenge alone. Over the years, there have been election petitions and these challenges coming. And it has been examined by the courts of law and such. What has been demonstrated to the court as evidence of tampering are machines which were made by the allegers. They themselves made their own EVMs and they showed that their own EVMs can be tampered with. Now the court said, you may make a machine which is tamperable and you are showing to us, but the election commission EVM, you please show that that can be tampered. The material thing is that it is election commission EVM which was used in the poll. The allegation is against that, but you are making your own machine and you are trying to say that I can tamper my own machine. Now we are not interested in this kind of a statement at all.
If you take the Indian EVM machine, the PCBA that what you have, many people have no idea what is there on it, what is the bill of quantities or how the design is done. It's not transparent.
Today you've got a VPAT where the voter himself is verifying this vote while he's casting the vote. So what is the role of the chip? How is the chip important? The program is completely written by the people. It cannot be changed later on. The voter has verified his vote. And during the transportation, etc., the whole media and political parties are following it. So where is the scope for any interference?
It is a specifically designed piece of hardware, which is not reprogrammable and which is designed specifically for election. And it is not a program written on a computer and which is then repackaged to become an EVM. This is the main difference about the Indian EVM versus the other EVMs.
More than 70% of the world is still on ballot papers. Do you mean they are still in the Stone Age? They are much advanced than us.
It is true that four countries went back from the EVM, but remember they were all using machines of the same company. It was a Dutch company called NetApp. If from that company, for instance, I use the analogy of a Mercedes car or a Volkswagen. Some problem was found with Volkswagen in one country. The cars are recalled from all the countries of the world. So if a NetApp machine was found defective, they were withdrawn from all four countries. So it is a one incident and not four different incidents, you know, which seems to exaggerate the problem.
It is a very strong feature of Indian elections that the machine, you may say this can be done, but that cannot be done because the machine is in the eye of the candidates themselves 100% of the time while it is being used for an election. The other part which is common and which has to do with the procedures is nobody knows which machine will go to which constituency. It is completely randomized. It is randomized in the presence of the candidates. And it is only then that the machine is allocated to a particular constituency.
In 2017, reports of EVMs malfunctioning hit the headlines. One such row that flared up was from Bhind in Madhya Pradesh. The Election Commission suspended 19 officials following the incident, but later a clean chit was given in the probe.
आपने तो और दूसरी चीज ये भी कहा कि कोई भी आपने बटन दबाया कि उसमें सबसे पहले कमल ही आया है तो ये तो आपने जैसा यूपी में लोग कह रहे थे आज उस पे कहीं ना कहीं सील लगा दी आपने कि कोई भी बटन दबाओ और कमल ही आता है सबसे पहले
देयर वाज सम जेन्युइन टेक्निकल प्रॉब्लम द मशीन हैड कम फ्रॉम यूपी Their old data had not been wiped out by a reset button that should have been used. So in any case, out of millions of machines, one or two or three stray cases do not make my machines suspect.
As free and fair elections are the backbone of democracy, citizens who are entitled to vote must be free to make their choice. And political parties have a right to contest in all fairness.
In the ideal voting system, nobody should be able to influence the voter while he is voting, whether it is in the ballot unit or whether it's a ballot paper, which is why he is isolated during the process of casting his ballot in a separate kiosk.
whether you are voting or not voting, voting for whom, it should all be just known to you. So, and it had consequences. Suppose your candidate lives in the neighborhood and he is a criminal and he loses by 50 votes. He will pick out every single person whom he knows who had not voted and would go and bite them up. To guard against reprisal, Supreme Court said that you should go press a button where your non-voting will be anonymous.
In 2013, voters were granted the right not to vote or exercise a blank vote. Nota or none of the above button was instituted on the electronic voting machine, and India became the 14th country to institute Nota.
Contrary to public perception, Nota has not created right to reject. People go and vote. 99 vote for Nota and 1 vote for you. For us, you are the winner because that's the only valid known vote. All others are blank votes.
Almost 1.74 million VVPAT machines will be deployed for the upcoming Lok Sabha elections. At present, VVPAT slips in one polling station per constituency are tallied with EVM results. Most political parties have been demanding that this number should be increased to a reasonable percentage.
Because of time constraint, we are demanding 50%. Even to count 100% EVPAT, it is not a big issue. It is not going to cost more. No equipment is required. And at the same time, it is going to take some more time. For democracy, for creating confidence, they can do the job.
Election Commission has ordered that the one slip from every constituency will be counted, which makes it about 250 to 300 booths in one constituency. To my mind, that should improve, because one is too less. So let there be a percentage. Reasonable percentage. I'm of the opinion that 5% should be good enough.
The Indian machine is the most secure in the world, and that its security does not leave anything in doubt.
A lot of work has gone to see that the EVMs will give the most honest result ever. And therefore, they can vote without any fear that their vote will be tampered with. Without doubt, we can say that thing, and they should participate in the voting anyway.
Every election has its problem, it has its scale and magnitude, and it is only getting bigger. The last general election was the biggest in electoral history of the world. The next one will be even bigger.
तो एक नागरिक होने के नाते इस देश की सरकार में मेरी एक भागीदारी होनी चाहिए, इसलिए मैं वोट करता हूँ।
नहीं जानती कि कौन पार्टी आएगी, जो भी पार्टी आएगी, उसे हम लोग एक्सपेक्ट करते हैं कि वो प्रोग्रेस करे और मोर प्रोग्रेस करे।
क्या फायदा नहीं है तो इसीलिए दे देते हैं, सरकार है, सरकार करके ये तो वोट छोड़ करके क्या करेंगे।
जब देश सो रहा है, वोट दे दो आप, क्या हो रहा है, कुछ क्या मतलब वोट देने से? अरे हम वोट किसको दे रहे हो ये नहीं मालूम हमें, तो क्या मतलब वोट देने से?
उम्मीद यही रहती है कि जिसको हम वोट करें वो आके एक चेंज लाए सोसाइटी में हमारे, और जिसको हमने वोट डाला है वो कल को हमारी बातें सुने।
थैंक्स फॉर वॉचिंग द वीडियो। फॉर मोर सच न्यूज एंड अपडेट्स प्लीज लाइक शेयर एंड सब्सक्राइब टू इंडिया टुडे। ऑल्सो चेक आउट अदर ग्रेट वीडियोस फ्रॉम आवर चैनल। वी नो यू विल लव टू।